Yeah, I got that big fatty natty. Big fatty natty growing on the side of my natty. Big fatty natty. You can't see it. I just put an updated video on my vlog channel regarding my locks, and there's a pretty good shot of my natty fatty in the back. So you can go check that out. Can check it out if you like. Yo, Wagwan, it's that guy. Snotlocks, Snot Nation, doing another dreadlock related video. Just uploaded one on Tim Duncan's locks. Man has some great high top freeforms these days, especially for his age at 43. But today I'm realizing that one of his players on the San Antonio Spurs, Lonnie Walker IV, also has an even epicer set of freeform locks that are high top as well. So make sure you stay tuned, stay subscribed. This is Knot Nation. And now that we're in the video, getting into the screen, doing the damn thing with the reviews, Lonnie Walker, hailing in Miami, Florida, has some epic locks. On the verge of becoming a Pelika Paulownika, to be honest. And this dude's really young. I'm happy to see people like this embracing the locks in the limelight. Mr. Lonnie Walker IV, American pro basketball player for the Spurs in the NBA. He played high school basketball for Reading High School in Pennsylvania, signed a letter of intent to continue his career at the University of Miami. Sorry, he's not from Florida. He is from Pennsylvania, but his hair says that he's from Florida, I must say. Checking out some images of Mr. Lonnie Walker here. Lonnie Walker, should call him Lock Walker, has some crazy high top freeforms going on, probably a few years in at this point. And haven't been separated, just shaved on the sides into a huge high top here. This, an example of them when they were first starting out. This being them more now as they're gaining some length. Crazy hair. So he's basically got an afro on the top of his head that is all locked up into one growing up. And when a lock is this strong and this thick, this will grow up for a long time. It's gonna have some strength. Shout outs Freeform Prophet on YouTube. He's got a lock similar to this. I don't even have a name for this type of lock style. If anybody has a name that you call this, please let me know in the comments below. But he is a good YouTuber to watch out for. With hair that's like crazy standing up. Even after 5 years of growing it, it's still standing up. It's like the ultimate baby dread that doesn't drop. Compared to this dude here, who's got the twist, the two-strand twist, the very scalpy look that we've seen quite often. When Lonnie Walker jumps into the field playing with hair like this, it definitely makes him stand out from the crowd. And it's just insane to see the strength of his roots here. Now, my question is, it would probably be tough to get right down to the nitty-gritty to wash his scalp underneath all this. So it'd be interesting to see how he does wash his hair. But to see where his locks came from, it's pretty remarkable to go from that to boom, something like this. And it almost seems like it's being shaved on the sides and maybe even a little here. And there's only one little dread here falling down on the entirety of his head. Like a 70s ad. Look at how he's got his hat on. This is hilarious. It just balances on the top of his head. What? Oh, man. Lonnie Walker's locks looking legendary already, and the dude's only 21 years old. Hair like this doesn't normally last that long in the NBA. Alfred Payton having one very similar. Look at how the hat just hovers on his head like that. It's like a magic hat. How'd he do that? Here's a little close up. You can see that it actually does look pretty maintained around here. Looks pretty fresh. This lock here looking like a shape of its own. Even the tips are sun bleached a little bit there. Changing colors in the sunshine after having his locks for that long. Yo, honestly, might be one of the most legendary locks in the NBA since Alfred Payton. Like, these are just insane. We're getting such good images here off of Google. Won't even need to really visit his Instagram. because these are looking like they're pretty up to date. Now, if you want to grow locks like this, obviously type 4 hair does work the best. Not to say it's the only type of hair that can do this. You know, there is type 3 and even type 2C that could probably get close to this. But his locks, though, you're obviously just leaving them, washing them and going and doing zero separation at all. Because if you were to separate these, they would start to fall down. And obviously Lonnie wants them up. It probably does help with his game because they don't get in his hair. And his hair doesn't get in his face at all while he's playing. And he's still able to have long locks. Only in the NBA you could probably do this, because if a guy tried to do this in the NFL, you wouldn't be able to get the helmet on his head. It would be a hovering helmet, just like his hovering hat. But dude does have some pretty epic locks. Mike Conley's freeform locks looking mad different, even though they're both freeforms, and it's cool to see. But honestly, I would almost call this a plica at this point, because it's just one big dread up on top of his head. You know, if he were to grow this for 20 years, 10 years, and into one big dread, it would fall down eventually, and it would be a plica. So, you know, it's actually really cool to see Lonnie Walker here making the plica polonica in style once again. And he's doing it in a way that's in the limelight. All he needs is to... Now that's where the real courage comes into play, is how long can you grow that plica, boy? You know what I'm saying? Damn, that was fun reviewing this video. Oh shit, I messed up. This video is gonna be out of sync because I'm doing it while I'm exporting another video. So I'm gonna cut it short. Thanks for watching this video on Plica Polonica, and I'll talk to you guys later. The